This is unfortunately a true story. This is the first poem I ever had published, you know, I think about 4 years ago, and I wrote and I sent this off to the Evergreen Review, who, you know, had published Jack Kerouac and Allen Ginsberg and William Burroughs and Gary Snyder, and I said Fat Chance, and I got published in this wonderful journal. So it's called Don't Thank Me for Serving. I wrote this because I was really mad. I sat on this for so many years and finally decided to put it on paper. Montgomery, Alabama, the year is 1965, and George Wallace has just been elected governor of the state on the platform of segregation now, segregation tomorrow, and segregation always. Ku Klux Klan leader Asa Carter has written Wallace's inaugural address, and there is little doubt where the people of Alabama stand on human rights. The overt signs of racism new to this Massachusetts native are everywhere. African Americans are called Negroes or worse, and as far as I can see, Negroes still sit towards the back of those big, oversized, gas-guzzling buses, even though it has been several years since Rosa Parks inspired bus strike. A large Confederate flag hangs proudly and defiantly over the state capitol building, a reminder of the war between the Yankees and the Americans. The American flag is displayed on the top of a smaller building, barely visible behind the capitol. I'm on leave with two other soldiers from medical training school at Gunter Air Force Base. We are to become medics. James is from Chicago and Wally is from California, and our experience with racism is limited. We are dressed in our civilian clothes as we walk into a downtown diner. It feels good to be out of uniform, but it doesn't help us fit in. It's as if every set of eyes in the diner is watching us. They know we're not from these parts, and our ways are strange to them. We stereotype them, too. They move slowly, but the longer we sit, it's becoming increasingly obvious that we are being ignored. I motion to the waitress and ask her if we can be served. She shakes her head and tells us that they don't serve Negroes in this establishment, and James is a Negro. Now, I imagine they know we are in the military and defending their rights, but racism knows no favorites. Shocked and indignant and embarrassed, we have little choice but to leave to a chorus of smiles and smirks. It's difficult to maintain dignity in such an environment. I'm angry and I'm hurt, and I want to tell them off, but I can see by the look in their eyes that they are used to settling such matters with violence, not words. Martin Luther King has just organized a freedom march from Montgomery to Selma, and the natives are restless. Their way of life is being threatened, and they take their right to treat people as inferior very seriously. In fact, just last year, three freedom fighters have disappeared for 3 months before showing up on a dam, having been lynched, beaten, and shot. Two of them were white. The men at this diner are big men with small ideas and passionately ready to defend them at any cost. They see themselves as loyal Americans defending their freedoms. The freedom to teach their children racism and bigotry, homophobia, xenophobia, anti-Semitism, and chauvinism, asking me to go to Southeast Asia to kill yellow people so they can stay home and subjugate black people. I'm not going to kill for you, so don't thank me for serving. Like Dr. King, I have a dream. I have a dream that someday I'll be able to thank the people in this diner for serving. Thank you for serving my brother a cup of coffee. Thank you for buying him breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Thank you for inviting him to your home to meet his wife, your wife and child, because he took the moral high ground while you bathed in white hoods, taunt ropes, and bloody crosses. The irony is, James, Wally, and I are not being asked to kill. We are being asked to save lives. We don't carry weapons. We are medics. James is going to save lives. Boys from New York, California, and Idaho, maybe even Alabama or Mississippi. It might even be the son of one of the big men with small ideas in this diner. It might be their son laying on the ground, wounded, with his guts exposed, crying out for his mama. And James isn't going to ask if she works at a diner in Montgomery. He doesn't care. James is going to save his life, because every life is precious, regardless of ideology. All souls rise up together. The next generation needs to know better. So don't thank me for serving you or the country you live in. I'm serving a higher power. Waitress, can I get a cup of coffee over here?